Good morning guys, welcome. So here is another important video that you might not want to miss. So what is it related? Yes, it is something related to brakes. So that is why I said it is important. So what is it related? So it is something which is related to the brake booster or what do you say, vacuum servo. So the thing here is, so as these cars get older, the brake vacuum hose to the brake servo or the brake booster, which is this pipe which goes from here and it goes and connects to the brake booster. So it is made out of plastic, and with age this plastic gets brittle and it will start to break. It will start to crack. So how do you check for this, and what made me do this video is, from the past few days I was, you know, kind of observing that you know, the brakes are not so efficient, and in sudden brakes, you know, like you are when the vehicle is accelerating and you suddenly need to touch the brake, so that time the pedal feels very hard. So this is what prompted me to do a search, and what I found out was where these connectors, you can sorry, you can't see this, where the plastic pipe, I mean actually there was a continuous full plastic pipe which used to come and connect to this one way valve, okay, there was a crack underneath this where it was connected, and it was leaking a vacuum from here. This is what prompted me. This is what I found out. So what I eventually did is, I went across and checked all the connectors. I mean, I checked it before, I checked it after, and there is another one-way valve or filter kind of thing which is here. I connected both, I checked both the sides of it. I was surprised to find that all this portion had started to develop cracks. You should touch with your finger and feel for cracks, or you should see if there's any cracks, it will be visible. I had one piece with me which I, you know, removed from here, but sorry, I threw it away, so I could not, so sorry, I can't show you that also. So okay, we'll come to the solution. What I did, so what I did is, so here it used to be a full length plastic pipe. So this pipe which I use is copper pipe. Where to get copper pipes? So these copper pipes will be usually stocked in shops which you know, sell spares for domestic air conditioners. So these pipes will be available in those shops, and this one is a braided rubber hose. I will show you a sample. So this is a braided rubber hose. What is braided rubber hoses? You will have a fabric lining inside, so it will be very tough, and it will be relatively stiff also. It's not very soft rubber, it will be relatively stiff. So this I got from a, you know, commercial vehicle spare parts shops. They will sell this in meters. So this was like 200 rupees or something for a meter. So this is what I used to connect. So the thing here is, when this pipe cracks, no, we have to remove the pipe and we have to cut away the cracked portion, and we have to use this pipe for connection. The only thing you have to take care is this pipe, since it is you know, it is not so much flexible like a normal rubber pipe, but still it has some kind of flex to it. So when you are using it in length, like in this portion, see, these are all are small portions, but if you use these rubber hoses in length, the problem is once the vacuum comes, no, this, there is chances that this hose will, with vacuum, no, it will collapse like this. So to prevent that, I have inserted metal pieces inside this. Metal pieces in the sense, this copper pipe itself, no, it will fit properly inside the hose. So small length I'll cut and I'll insert it so that the hose won't collapse. Then one more thing which we have to take care is, these are plastic pipes. okay, these are plastic pipes. So when you insert the hose over it and you start to tight the, you know, hose clamps, what happens, there are chances that this pipe, upon pressure from the hose clamp, it might crack or crumble. So what we should do is, in the end of this plastic pipe, no, we have to insert, inside the plastic pipe, we have to insert a metal piece or metal sleeve. So for this also I used a different sized copper pipe. So it is there with me, but right now it's not available here. So you can cut that copper pipe in length and insert inside the plastic, so that once you tight it, no, once you insert the hose and tight it, the plastic pipe won't crumble. So this is one check that everyone should definitely do in their cars, if they are especially facing, or if they are feeling like there is an, the brakes are inefficient or brakes are not so good as it used to be before. So this is one mode or one check that everyone has to do. So in my case, I have changed almost the hose at all the connectors. See here, the plastic pipe got cracked, so the copper pipe comes here, and copper pipe is again connected to the one-way valve using a rubber hose. Then here again it is connected using a rubber hose. Then coming here also, the another one-way valve, I'm using a rubber hose to connect it. So this proves to be very efficient and reliable also, and there is some kind of additional flexibility also associated to it. So this overall has turned out very good. So I hope this video is useful to, or will become useful to, at least some of you in the future. Thank you.